Some of you don't even know who your father was. Some of you don't like, hey, Bishop, you know, I thank God for you. And, you know, that wasn't me. My father was a drunk. My father was an alcoholic. My father was dead. I don't even know who the man was. My mama won't even tell me who he was. And you just grieving over that whole process. That's why we thank God for Jesus. Because our original father, our father who art in heaven, your father, your real father, the father, your biological father, was simply the one that carried out the assignment that was on his life to get you birthed out into the earth realm. But he is not the one who conceived you. You were conceived by the sperma or the word and the mind of God before time began. And because you were conceived by your original father, your biological father was simply a part of your real father's process to get you out into the earth realm so that your real father can work on you and leave a legacy in you for who you're really supposed to be. You getting messed up. Oh, yeah, I told you I was going to bring this thing together. You getting messed up over your birth father, and he's not the one that conceived you. He's not the one that thought about you. He's not the one that made you. The Bible says, Lord, you made me. You conceived me. You thought about me before I was in my mother's womb, before there was a when or a where, before there was a here or there. God, you conceived me. You thought about me. You recognized me. You made me. You walked me through all of my days. And all God did, though, when I use the word sperma, there is a Latin word that comes out of the word word, means life, means sperm. And he used that particular word that he put out in the atmosphere, and he gave the assignment. I don't care how crazy it was. I don't care if it was in the back of an elevator. I don't care if it was on a honeymoon. I don't care how it happened. I don't care where it happened. I don't care when it happened. That man had an assignment to deliver you because God put that assignment on his life. He might have done it wrong. He might have done it too soon or too late, but he did what God gave him to do so your real father could deposit himself down in you. Oh, I told you I was going to get there. You feeling me? You messed up. Oh, my dad didn't do this. My dad didn't do that. I don't know my father. You need to get to know your real father, honey. Help me, Holy Ghost. Because you know what? That guy that birthed you into the earth realm, his job is done. Help me, Holy Ghost. Unless he's leading you back to God. See, the blessings that God gave me was that God gave me a natural father that connected me with my spiritual father. Help me, Holy Ghost. I remember very clearly. I remember very, very clearly. When I was about to finish this church and I couldn't get the job done, I went to my natural father and I sat down beside him. Help me. Hold me a minute, Jerry. I'm going to get this out. I sat down beside my father in his bedroom. He was 2 months from death. I knew he was dying. I sat there and I tried to tell him, Daddy, I can't get it done. I can't get it finished. We were 2 days from walking in this building and I couldn't not get it done. And while I sat there, I looked over at my father, my natural father, and he was sound asleep. He was snoring. He never heard one word I said. And it was at that moment that I realized this man can no longer help me. And I heard my real father speak to me and say, son, I've taken it from him because he can't handle it anymore. And I have given it to you. And I heard my real father say, rise, take up your bed and walk. Get up from there. Because as I was with Moses, so shall I be with you. Moses, my servant, is dead. Come on, Joshua, we got something else to do. You might not have had a good biological father, but you got a real father that is ready to bless you right now. Somebody better praise him. Somebody better praise him.